Hello everyone, welcome back to GK Code Labs. Today I'm going to give you a very short demo on how you can use Git and GitHub to maintain versions of your code using any of the IDEs. In this tutorial, I'll be using IntelliJ. So let's see how you can use Git and GitHub along with your IntelliJ project to maintain local and online repositories of your code. The prerequisites for this will be you should have an online GitHub account and the Git utility to be installed on your local machine. If you have not yet installed Git on your machine, you can go to Git SCM official website and download and install Git respective to your OS. It is available for all Linux, Mac and Windows. So I've already installed Git on my machine. Once Git is installed, you can verify the same using command git hyphen hyphen version. So you can see I have Git version 2.20, Windows version, installed on my machine. So let's open IntelliJ. You can see I have a demo project with simple minimal code. This is a Scala project. So keep in mind, if you want to have a version controlled Git repository, you have to create a local repository first that will maintain all the versions of your code on your local machine. Then to share it on GitHub, you can sync up the same local repository to GitHub or any other platform like Bitbucket, GitLab, etc. Any of these can solve your purpose to maintain your online repositories. Now let's dive in and see how you can get started and use Git with your project. First thing you have to do is go to VCS menu and click on Enable Version Control Integration. This will ask you which tool you want to use to maintain your VCS. You can select Git from here and click OK. You can see you will get a message, created Git repository in your whatever path your project lies. So this has created a local repository as I told you. And soon after your local repository is created, you can see your classes and other files have turned into red in font. This red in font means these files are yet not part of your local repository. You can click on this lower left icon and select version control. So once you create your local repository, all the files are marked as unversioned files. Unversioned files means that no matter your local repository is created, but your project files are not yet part of this. So this gives you another option to take only the required files to your repository. From this list of files, you can select whatever files you want. For example, here I want only my Scala classes to be part of my repository. So this gives complete list in itself. If you want, you can click here and group by directories. So you'll get similar structure as your project inside this menu. So I'll go to my source folder and right click on my required class, go to Git and click on add. If you see, once I click add, this file is now added to my local repository and its color is now green. Again, I'll open the same. You can see only practice 2, which I did not add to my local repository, is available. The one file which I added is now under default changed list. So let me add practice 2 also. Now you can see both the files are now in green color. That means both the files are now in my local repository. Or you can say just marked to be inside my local repositories. When will these be available in my local repository? When I commit, I'll come to that later. So here you can see most of the files, if you are using IntelliJ or any other IDE, will be IDE related. For IntelliJ, this is under .idea folder. You can see 141 files are there. So these are IntelliJ specific. So I do not want them ever to be inside my local repository. So for this, there is an option to create git ignore file. You can go to the root directory, right click new file and create a file with the name .gitignore. So first thing this will ask, as we have added a new file, it is asking, do you want to keep this new file into your local repository? I'll say, let's add it. You can see gitignore is also now in green color. So what this gitignore provides us, we can mention directories and files that we always want to ignore. As of now, I want to ignore everything lying inside my .idea directory. So I can ignore all of them like .idea slash. Once you save it, you can see the idea directory, all 141 files have vanished. So it will never give us option version those idea files. You can close it. Now the next step would be to commit these files. To commit, you can go to VCS and click on commit, or there is a shortcut Control plus K. Here it will give you options of what all files you want to commit. Still, if you change your mind and if you want to commit any of the unversioned files, you can select from here. I'll commit git ignore also. In total, it's prompting we have three files that are to be committed. Input any commit message, like first commit and click on commit. If your file has some kind of errors, it will prompt you. Otherwise, you can go ahead and commit. You can see the message three files committed as first commit, which was our commit message. Now, next thing is to post these changes into our online GitHub repository. To do that, again go to VCS, go to import into version and click on share project on GitHub. Once you do that, you will have an option to create your repository with any name. You can mention the same name here. I'll mention new and any description. I'll mention the same description and click on share. You can see the message as successfully shared project on GitHub. And this will happen if you have already logged into GitHub from your IntelliJ. If not, there will be just one more additional step, which IntelliJ will automatically prompt you to log into your online GitHub account. Let me go to my online GitHub account. I'll refresh it. You can see Scala training new. A new repository has been created. And if you click on this, we'll have the content whatever we have committed. First, we committed git ignore file. You can see .idea/ that we added. And another is the main folder structure, that is source, main, Scala. And we have two Scala classes inside this. So guys, this was a simple way you can maintain your online repositories using any of your IDE. If you find this helpful, please hit that like button and please subscribe to my channel if you have not already done. Thank you guys. See you later.